Hi, thanks for tuning in to Exact Weather News and Traffic. I'm Exact Weather Meteorologist Jay Galley. As we look outside through our tower camera, as you can see, Lee Circle there off in the distance, Crescent City Connection. Notice we do have lots of cloud cover. A little bit of haze in the air, that's a little bit of the moisture that we're seeing. And by this afternoon, after we start working in some daytime heating, we are going to see some of those puffy white clouds developing as well. We're going to get the clouds as well because we're going to see a cold front pushing through here. And there it is right there, situated right across Oklahoma, dropping some snowfall across parts of New Mexico as well as Texas as well. We're not going to see any rainfall. You know what? We're not going to see a whole lot of rainfall either. There's a cold front as it continues pushing to the south. We could see maybe an isolated shower, maybe a thunderstorm. Rain chances are going to be minimal. More on that in a moment. Let's go out to the tropics. National Hurricane Center watching this area of disturbed weather. 0% chance, which is rather low, of course. We're not worried about that. And you know what? We're not really worried about Rena either. Rena was a Category 2 hurricane, now nothing more than a Category 1 storm. We thought Rena was going to turn into a Category 3. Reconnaissance aircraft went out there and said Rena's not that strong. Category 1, max sustained winds of 75 miles per hour. Check out the path. Rena's going to cross over the Yucatan Peninsula. As she interacts with the land, she's going to weaken and diminish to a tropical storm, then move to the north northeast, and then recurve back around, probably hanging in this general area. We thought maybe that Rena would move across into the Florida Straits, and that's not going to happen. Southeast Louisiana, southern Mississippi, and the United States have nothing to worry about. Here's your forecast model. We are tracking this front. This is 6:30 this evening. The front is going to be actually situated down here. A lot of the rainfall is going to be occurring behind the front. As you can see, some showers and storms will push through Louisiana, Mississippi. But for us down here in southeastern Louisiana, this is by lunchtime tomorrow. This is about all we're going to see, maybe a few spotty showers. By tomorrow afternoon into tomorrow evening, we will start to clear out, leading to a very nice weekend, although it's going to be cooler and breezy. For today, upper 70s, lower to mid-80s, increasing clouds, a little warm, a little humid. Overnight tonight and into tomorrow, expect temperatures to be in the mid-50s to mid-60s, maybe an isolated shower at least through tomorrow, maybe a few areas of fog. Check out your 7-day ExactCast because as this cold front passes, we are going to cool off your temperatures. Come Saturday, winds are going to be blowing 15 to 20 miles per hour, setting up for a weekend that's going to be filled with sunshine, but a little cool and a little breezy. Thanks for tuning in.